When we say we're looking for change, standing for change, it's not just the way we behave, the way we let the government, previous government, did certain job, and we didn't find it acceptable. So now we decided to embrace the change word, and what's going on now in APC, I don't think is really, really showing us that change. In that, it looks like the way things are going now, some people are being imposed onto some people, and we shouldn't allow that, encourage that. My problem with the previous, the previous seats, I don't want to use the word hooligans, but there were problems. They do not deliberate, they do not dialogue the way they should. They represent us in legislative. But then when you do represent us, you should have a sort of discipline. And previously, I didn't find any discipline here. And since we're coming into this, embracing this new change, the first thing I expect us to talk about is discipline. And if they cannot sit down and pick, discuss, dialogue, and pick who they want for certain things, and then expect somebody else to impose somebody on you, the same, coming back to that word impose. If you have to force somebody to accept this or accept that, then I don't see that change. We're going back to what the way we were. And then most of the things we came here, I came all the way from England for this change, and if I do not see things happening, then I'll go back again disappointed. But I believe in President Buhari, and I believe he will do exactly as he preached. You know, they say practice what you preach. I believe he will practice what he preached, but then the other people following him should also embrace and then at least learn from this gentleman. A home can never be a home without a woman. Regardless backstabbing of others in the past, this woman didn't do well, this didn't do well. But I still believe a woman is the foundation of every home. And if you cannot, any man that cannot keep his home, take for instance in America, we don't take scandals here seriously. But all the places, politicians, scandals should be taken seriously. And then if you put in a cabinet without sufficient women in it, I'm not saying we have to have equal rights. Yes, it shouldn't be equal right, but we should have say, serious say. I have another NGO that I represent, I founded, I represent in this country. It's called the Center for Prevention of Exploitation of Women and Children. Basically, the women and children in this country are really exploited somehow, and we have to have a foundation. And without a woman, there will be no foundation. So a woman should have a solid stay in this government.
Our intention is for change, change for good, change this country for better, an individual for better. But I am not feeling too bad, and I'm feeling too bad because what people have been calling, challenging, and what APC leaders are doing, that is where I feel bad also. I don't know how far distance has gone to, but it is my belief that when we say change and we mean justice, that is our motto. We allow people to do what is suitable for them and what is supposed to do. By allowing people to vote, we have suffered. Look at me. It's during the struggle for change that have made me, I had this accident. I had this accident and I've been down for 3 months just to look for this change. And if we are dying for this change, and this change cannot be useful, I think there is no how that somebody will continue to risk his life because he wants to change the situation of this country. I am praying that this change will come to realize actualization, because we fought for this change and we are hoping for this change. And we are praying that this change will come to stand. For people to walk out for something that they don't know, I will not say they have done wrong. You cannot just call me for something that I don't know and I start doing it. I may be foolish. But if this change as a party, I'm a member of this party. Every candidate is more or less as a son. It's just like you have your children as a father, as a mother. Everybody is supposed to have your equal love. Even if you have a different emotion on one child, you don't show it to the eye of the others. You don't show it to the eyes of the others. You have to stand and look and walk to the will or to the progress of your family and the problem of children to see that they go forward and they walk according to what you want. You cannot, because if your child offended you, can you just silence him and begin to bring some other, that child will go astray. And we are praying for this chain that we have risked our life, our soul. This is before we make this chain, we make all the collective efforts, NGOs, individual, and so on, that this thing come to actualization. And I hope this chain will not be destroyed. This chain will not be destroyed. Because in my state, I know people die, they risk their life, they shoot them, they risk their life. Youth even spend 1 week without even bathing, without drinking water. Bauchi State. I know how we fought. And me, I know how I go through if this campaign and how I survive. If I struggle to this chain, to stand, and with my injury, and I will lose it. For some people to come and pick it, as seems they have picked a dustbin or picked a gift from a street, I think I will not be happy. I will not be happy because this is just what we are struggling for. We are struggling for change, and we struggle for justice.